By the way, last week in July 4th, you know what that means. The new unemployment numbers are here. The new unemployment numbers are here.
The government said the unemployment rate dropped to 9.5%, but the economy's still losing jobs. 125,000 in June. Allison Kosick at the New York Stock Exchange.
We find that the job losses last month were due to the expected end of the line for temporary census workers, but private sector hiring was a bit weaker than expected.
Sorry, I didn't quite catch the dire economic news over your indoor fireworks celebration. The economy is collapsing.
Ooh.
Of course, Wall Street wasn't the only ones trying to get America to look on the bright side. Imagine if we hadn't had the stimulus.
It's hard to argue sometimes things would have been a lot worse. Right? So people kind of say, yeah, but unemployment's still at 9.6. Yes, but it's not 12 or 13. Or 15.
Yes. Yes, I believe we can all agree, as Americans, there are many numbers bigger than 9. I think we can thank our lucky stars it's not 35, or, I don't know, 1,000%. I think we should remain thankful it's not 1,000,000% unemployment. Of course, things could also be better, like if everything had gone according to the administration's own projections from early 2009. Which said that the stimulus would cap unemployment at 8%. With the 9%+ jobless rate we have now, the doomsday scenario if Congress didn't pass the plan. Of course, not everyone in America has lost their job. For example, Christina Romer, the White House economist who made that chart. She apparently is still working.